Monday the 13th of June and I'm heading off on a little day trip to Akaroa, or I'm going to stay the night, and I didn't check the forecast until after I'd booked the trip, so it's going to be raining and apparently windy, but hopefully I'll find a nice little cafe that ends up being good. I just about missed my bus from Christchurch to Akaroa because I'd booked to hop on at the museum and I missed the number 17 bus that was going to take me from Opawa to the city centre. So instead I had to walk and run through morning traffic, not directly through the traffic, of course I waited at the lights, to the city centre, and I also called the office of the Akaroa connection just to let them know that I was running late, and luckily I made it on time. I went to the bus exchange instead because it was a little bit closer. And it was a lovely journey. The driver gave me a lovely commentary. We got to stop off at Little River and have a break. And then when I got here, it was quite cloudy and cold. And I went to the museum and had a look around, and it started spitting. So I looked around the old courthouse and the oldest home in Akaroa, and just some old artefacts, some interesting things in the museum. And then I went to the little four square supermarket and got lunch, and I was luckily allowed into my room early. And the sun's come out, so it looks a little bit nicer out there now, so I might do a walk to the old French cemetery. So I'm at the old French cemetery and it was a very short walk up the hill. It was only about 2 minutes. I thought I read on a sign that it would be 45 minutes, so I'm pleasantly surprised. And I was also expecting headstones, but there aren't any headstones. Instead, I think this enclosure is where the first French settlers were buried, and there's this monument with some names. And the earliest known burial took place in May 1842, apparently. It's very atmospheric up here. Got the last of the sun, or our last hour of sun, and you can hear pigeons' wings and birds chirping softly. Some kind of building or something going on up there, so I turn around and then head back down and see what else I can find. I just saw a wood pigeon fly low across the road.
light was first shone here in the year 1880. And because of COVID-19, the interior is now closed to the public for the time being. Kia ora everybody. It's a beautiful sunny day. I'm so glad because yesterday was so cold and rainy, but today is comparatively balmy. So far I left my hotel, went to the Four Square supermarket and had some chocolate muesli bars and mandarin for breakfast. Then, which I ate by the old war memorial that I showed you yesterday. And then I walked along the shoreline and took some photos of the sea and boats and things like that. And then I went to the old lighthouse, which I showed you guys, and then I just kept going along the shoreline past some houses and the sewage treatment plant, and I think I saw the guy who runs the museum picking some kind of flowers off a bush. Maybe he's making tea and putting them into a net. It was interesting. I'm a bit of a spy because I've got a good memory for faces, so watch out. If I ever meet you, I'll be bound to recognize you, even if I see you out of context somewhere else. And then I've just kept going along the shoreline. Now I'm a few hundred metres past the sewage treatment plant and just enjoying the peace and quiet. And as far as I'm aware, there isn't anybody else here. Sea is beautiful. And so I'm probably just going to do a bit of walking around. I think there's another old cemetery I might have a look at. And then I might go kayaking. I'm going to check out the old library. I've got a lot of time because my bus doesn't come and collect me till 4 p.m. So I went to the ice site and tried to go kayaking, but the lady there said that it's too windy today. Although the wind has died down, it was very windy earlier. And so now I'm just in the Garden of Tane, looking for one of the old Anglican cemeteries and enjoying the views. So that tree up there is supposedly a walnut tree, and then here is a woolly pine tree, this little fence to protect it.